we're gonna start by just igniting a fire. So we'll talk about extending the siege. So we have a flow pack open. So this is simulating a door open. As you can see, it's growing. It's opening. We're just gonna show it as it grows. So we're gonna simulate right now, fire starting, family runs out, or people run out, leave the door open, so the fire's gonna be able to grow. Right now as the flow path enters. So right now we have a bifocal flow path. We only have one opening, so it's coming in one way, and then find its way out, so it's all through the same opening.
What stage of fire is
it? Right now we're in the incipient stage. So it's starting to build up, trying to let it build up a little bit, and we'll see how this goes. So we're in closing flow path right now. Limit it. So right now we're starved with the oxygen, so it's died off. And then we're gonna open our flow path. Let it go again. See if it reignites. So it's getting here. So we're just gonna let the line up to go.
Stick it in the fire. We'll light up. Would you bring a tick? That helps. That helps.
So we're gonna open up this door right here to simulate. Going open.
Temperature.
We're gonna see the smoke start pouring in the next room. It's gonna start filling, and once this heats up, once the gas gets hot enough, the room temperature gets hot, that's gonna ignite.
Did you open the room right now?
Yeah, we opened the. Right now, just looking at our flow path inside, you can see our heat's rising, our smoke's rising, little by little starting to sink in. And if you go in this corner, you can see it sucking into this next room. It's our flow path opening, so it's going into the next.
It'll hit it when it's there. You go. It points to where it's taking.
I think it's reflecting. It sees up. What if you go on the other side?
We're just gonna throw some context in the second room.
Yeah, see, 640. So it doesn't do it to the glass.
So we're opening up another door, so create a flow path sucking into the next room. You can really start to see it. It's coming in one door, coming out the next. So we're we're gonna close our first door, make a new pull path, so a new exit. And it's gonna start sucking out the second door, because now our flow path, and hopefully we're gonna inhibit the fire to come here. So if we roll up to a fire right now, we could be reading our smoke. So our smoke's clear or white, so we have a clean burning fire, burning wood. That's all we're burning right now. So our smoke fire, if you come look at our glass, you can see our thermal balance inside of our occupancy, and low by low starting to sink. We're gonna open this first door again, let it get some more air, let it reignite, see if we can ignite some of those gases.
I kind of wonder if it's from OSB or just I think we need to suck one in a way. A little bit and light it up. No, it's just thick. Yeah, so it takes a little bit of a long time to. Whoa, move that propane.
Who's our
have to cut this one out.
So at this point, we're gonna open the attic space, try to let it get in the attic, see if we can run the attic. So as you can see, we have our fire, it's heating up, we're starting to roll. We'll see if we can start rolling into our next door. We also have flames coming out of our alpha side. So we're finally starting to heat up. So we have fire in our attic space. And then also we have this door open and this door, so we have our flow path going. We're starting to slightly roll into our second door right here. You can see, and this room's starting to really go. You can really see a flash rolling over up here as you come close. And then we have smoke going through all our attic space right now. So we have some contents in here, just some wood. So at this point, I'm gonna open just one of our attic spaces in this, see if we could get this going just by having an attic roll. So we'll start to heat up in there. And as you can see, we're starting to pour our gases or smoke into this room. Initial origin room, but we do have heavy smoke. So we at this point similar to on scene, we're gonna close up this air. Starving our fire of oxygen right now. So we're gonna open the beds up, let this air back in, feed it, and see it reignite. Oh, we might just go in. Not hot enough. So we'll feed some more, put some more stuff in there. There you go. Here's some more. It's cool, you can see the gas inside.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You guys like the room? Or did it light on its own?
Did you light that room, Daniel, or did that light on its own? Because that was already going.
Yeah. We just do it, I guess, put some more in there.
I guess it's.
We're gonna open up our warehouse section. There's the same that people are smoking, come open up. So we're pouring out a good amount of smoke, thick volume with a good density. Color's still white, we're still burning just natural wood materials and the combustibles. Now we're just gonna see the flow paths continue to see how this progresses.
If we get PW and put that fire out in the whole time.
So just by we closed up our front door. So our glass broke, so we dropped the gas. So now it's free burning. And we're just gonna let it burn, continue to burn, and now it's gonna be open or combustible, so there's no way to control our flow path, so this should really get going. So we're gonna simulate, we've lost this. So at this point we're gonna vent. So we're gonna try to limit the fire right here. So we're gonna vent, do a commercial cut. We have fire coming out of our hose. And we're gonna try to limit the fire to this corner right here. So as you can see, our commercial cut, we did a commercial. We're starting to roll over though, so that's not working. So we're gonna do another commercial cut, another strip cut. Start to roll over it. And we're gonna try to limit and save our main portion in our warehouse. We have heavy smoke damage in there right now. So we're having lots of fire come out our first hole, so that was enough. So we still have fire come out this hole. So we are limiting it. And then at this point, when we vented, we'd have interior crews coordinating, so we'd vent in coordination with our interior crews.
See if you open that one or close this one.
So we're gonna close this one back up and just simulate once again that we just had that first hole. And then we have a lot of fire, so that in real life for simulating that's not gonna be enough. So we need to do another cut because that's gonna continue to spread.
There's not a firewall anywhere.
It's all common. It's all common.
And then we currently have a firewall between our warehouse and then our just our three businesses.
No, I don't. It's all common.
So that's hard.
So it's stood right about 1,000, over 1,000 degrees.
Not in that attic. So right now our attic space is open.
That's the last thing you want to have.
So we're gonna close our commercial cuts and just let the fire run the attic and see if we can just get it going.
Those are usually going.
It is bright right here.
It doesn't matter. It's
just by running the attic. So we're gonna open up our compartment, the firewall. And right now you can really see the smoke. Our thermal layer is sinking. We have fire rolling into our ceiling in the warehouse. It's just rolling the ceiling. Our thermal layer is slowing in. It's lowering. Just in regards to smoke, we're gonna put a little bit of water just for our just read smoke, see how it looks. So as we put water on the fire, our color of our smoke is changing. Then just check the coordination. Okay, we have our fire rolling in the main room. We're going to close our door to pull our flow path since we can't control any of that to see what happens. So you have our fire rolling in to this our main room. Occupancy, we only have our flow path in. We have no flow path over here. It's all from the other side. So we're going to try to get this to flash over. See, there's like almost zero visibility in here. Our upper gases are starting to heat. So I started fingering the ceiling. We now have a part of our glass in the Charlie's side is cracked, so now we have a flow path on both sides. And now it's really starting to creep in. Initial first rooms, the whole roof is already caved in. That's all coming down right now, starting to come down. So as we saw with our commercial cuts, with actual water going on, we probably could save this portion initially, coordinating with ventilation. Yeah, now we're in for a complete flash over in our warehouse. Now we have fire coming out of our room of dead wood. rear smoke. Got me. Put some water on it, but it's really not doing anything. Limited, but it's just starting to creep back in. Burn again.
It's gonna light that roof right there. Pull it out, see what happens. Okay. It's gonna light that one. I'm excited. Let's do it again. Not at all. It didn't exactly do what I thought it would do.
I like what you're talking about. I think we put like a lighting carpet on the ground. So you have some off-gas and like actually we have to put some plastic blades in there.
Yeah, I hear you. Yeah.
I think that will
I kind of wonder if we should do like actually simulate it. Okay, this is a body paint shop, has like a bunch of paint cans in there. Look at his face, he's so excited.
He's like, this is what fire insurance is up in here.
It reminds me of Kern. Maybe I should go back. Daniel, shoot it from up top down.
we always go right to five, but we don't want to blast ourselves, right?